free to play, dude.
But
I think the economy is kind of fucked.
It kind of sounds like you're going to be able to buy in-game currency with real money.
You have to pay money to communicate in general chat? Oh man. This is so nice. Wow. What a good game.
Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. I'm working in this industry for over 20 years now as an environment artist, and I also like to consume what this industry creates in my spare time. In this video, I'll react to Brian reacting to other content creators saying stuff about the game. Brian is the lead game designer of this game. That means he has a say in whatever decisions are pushed by anyone in that company, regardless of position and so on. I want to quickly address something that's being said over and over again, and people actually believe that is true, and they just regurgitate that following statement everywhere, and I find it pretty dumb. Pay to win is not affecting me. I just kill them and loot their stuff, making them look like clowns. Bro. Yeah, it's true. It doesn't affect most streamers because they are decent at the game, but the little guy gets wrecked. The mental gymnastics those guys do is just an excuse for them to, I don't know, they don't fall from grace with happy developers, you know. I'm sorry, but this is the truth. And second thing, and this one really annoys me as well, and again, I saw some creators saying this, the fact that Abby sells you gear for real money gets rid of real money trading. Oh my fucking god, bro. First of all, I'm pretty sure less people RMT than buy direct in-game shop for obvious reasons. Let's just say it's more convenient to buy from in-game shop than to go to some, I don't know, shady website and leave there your credit card, whatever information. You don't want that. So yeah, this is bullshit. This is complete bullshit, bro. Stop spreading that because it's dumb. And second of all, no idea what kind of logic is that. It's like, oh, thank God I didn't get a brain tumor. I got one in my lungs. This is the most convenient way for the developers to get rid of RMT, whatever. My point is, if you believe any of the two points I just addressed, you can dislike the video already. Now, short shameless plug here. If you find anything useful in this, give this channel some love. Help your boy get to the 1000 subs. At that point, I'll do some giveaway. With that crap out of the way, let's get on with the video. Brian didn't address the fact that on the Angry Joe show, someone said the economy is fucked because of the option to buy in-game currency for real money. Instead, he addresses Angry Joe's praise for quality of life features of the product, saying that's one of their primary focuses. And yeah, this doesn't need explaining, man. Everyone can see and we can feel it in-game. I think everyone but Tarkov Sweatlords agree that having unnecessary complicated steps when you don't need to is bad. Then he says the economic aspect of the game is an ongoing task and they are gathering data and probably adjust it from there. Well, that's the thing. If you don't buy pay-to-win stuff in the shop, they will make the right adjustments, you know. This is key and I can't stress it enough. Let's move on, in hopes he addresses the elephant in the room at some point properly. But let's be real. When someone is working at a company and he does a piece like this, he won't say on camera, yeah, I know my company sucks, there were some poor decisions. No. They will not admit. What I'm trying to say is Brian isn't in some impossible spot right now. So with more content each raid, the market pricing will be more stable and reasonable. Bro, with those ammo prices, no. Do something with the ammo, bro. It's too expensive. Like, for real. Well, I doubt that makes any difference, Brian. If I work my heart out for 10 raids to get a set that someone can get with a single swipe, the market pricing is high, and this wouldn't be such a problem if we know everyone is in the same boat, you know? So by having the option to buy power in game, everyone can think at some point that the other guy swiped. And this might even lead to, I don't know, a more toxic environment. Even if that's not the case, this is how it will feel for most people. And by the way, this will be more visible later into early access, when people level up more and unlock better stuff. Now, some of you probably think this is an over-exaggeration. I don't think that's the case. Then we move to Landmark, who is sweating his ass off trying to deal with with a 4 squad, but fails at the last guy. The topic here is simple. Add solo queue for who wants it, you know? Of course, this will require some rebalancing of the spawn points and the distribution of loot. I'm guessing TLDR of it is this will take time, so it's not a feature that's around the corner.
Sure.
Then there's the topic of cheaters with Shroud, and I like the killcam feature. I saw it too yesterday in a raid and it's pretty cool. You can see impossible shots and you can replay it as much as you want. Neat feature and I like it. Then time for Big Fry, who's complaining about the fact that you can buy gear with real money. An entire video. So I hope Brian talks about it a bit more openly. And he says this: our principle is that money should not affect the fairness of raids. Our principle is that money should not affect the fairness of raid. In what universe this makes some sense, Brian? I don't get it. Whatever, bro. As I said, I'm sure you're in a difficult spot. You can't admit your company did a big boo-boo on camera, but you know it. Deep inside, you know it. That's not your principle, bro. Yeah, and I think you talk about the previous revision of the game or something in, I don't know, alternate timeline when this wasn't the case. Because in our current timeline, in the actual EA build, you can pretty much buy in-game currency with real money, bro. Yeah, full stop. As Big Fry says, let's not do mental gymnastics here and insult people's intelligence. But yeah, as I said 2 times already, it's normal you try to do this. But I hope you do the right thing in the end and get rid of that shit. Because it's bad. It's bad for the game in the first place. And you want the game to succeed, right? Okay, then the next sentence is... we will design very carefully without affecting the player experience. Oh. You're doing it. You're affecting it. Even if someone is oblivious to this, you affect him or her. And if not now, you will affect it in the future. I mean, come on. This is not right. Let me explain the thought process of the monetization department and why I think Brian here is a bit disingenuous. And tell me in the comments if you noticed this as well in various games. Sometimes a game starts with an outrageous monetization that upsets a lot of people, then quickly dialed it back so they look like they listen to the community.
Aww.
But you see, that was the plan all along. Over the course of 100 raids, the overall experience might not be that bad because I'm sure not many people will keep getting the best ammo all the time with real money, but still, you affect the players without them even knowing it. But they can feel it, you know? And their enjoyment of the game will degrade slowly because, yeah, nobody likes to get stomped. So what I'm trying to say is, the point of the monetization guy is to get as much money as possible without affecting the players, or in this case, to make the players think that there is no issue with monetization in your game. In early access, we'll only have a small amount of monetized content, mainly for the sake of convenience. And yeah, this statement scares me, to be honest, because if this is convenience, my gosh, guys, what are you doing? It is literally pay to win. Don't even try to argue this in the comments, by the way. So you have the secure boxes behind some sort of subscription, right? And that's okay, whatever, that's okay, I'm fine with that. But all these things will add up and in the end they'll create a miserable experience. Not now at the beginning, because people don't know what they are doing. They don't know the meta, they are so low level, they can't buy the best bullets, etc. But at some point in the near future, you all might be affected by this decision. So yeah, it's not convenience, man. This is pay to win. Later we'll have more personalization content, but we are still researching the possibilities. Yeah, so we are guinea pigs, you know? They are researching the possibility. With this, they take the pulse of the community, you know? And this is perfect for them because the game is not on Steam yet. So yeah, it will not tank on Steam. Mark my words, it will release without that bullshit we are complaining now. I'm pretty sure of it. And this statement is weird because usually companies have this part. He's talking about at release and then slowly push some of those conveniences, you know? I don't know. I feel this guy's got it the other way. Skill and knowledge are still the biggest factors of success in a raid, and spending money won't change that. Yeah, bro. Let me say it again because I need to. I'm amazed a lot of people believe this. Again, this is not a topic I'll respond in the comments because it's clear as day. If you put two equally skilled players in a level, the one who has higher tier ammo and armor wins 8 out of 10 probably. Come on, guys. Be honest with yourself. Then there's the Forbes point that, yeah, those make sense. And this is what a team of people who have a gaming game evolution deals with anyway. Improvements to the core gameplay, additions to the game, and making money while doing it. So yeah, this is what I wanted to cover in this video. I just want to add that in the West, Asian games need to change the monetization practices. You just can't have the same level of pay to win as in your country and call everything convenience, you know? I know it's convenient, but stop doing that. In the end, we can make a billion videos about the topic if the monetization guy has the data that tells him it's okay to keep it like this. Nothing will change. Nothing. So I hope this tips the balance a bit in our favor, because it's not in our interest. And I hope this game succeeds despite all this. I wish Brian here the best of luck, because he seems like a nice guy. But I'm not covering this game anymore if it stays like this. My guess is it won't by the time it goes live on Steam, but we'll see. And also drop a like if you agree so more people see this. As I said, we need to tip the balance in our favor. And no matter how skilled you are, trust me, this affects you. Thank you for watching, and until next time, take care and see ya.